ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله، وكفى بالله شهيدا. من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى، ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل وغوى. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإن أحد من المشركين استجارك فأجره حتى يسمع كلام الله ثم أبلغه مأمنه، ذلك بأنهم قوم لا يعلمون. My dear brothers and sisters, the greatest and the biggest gift and ni'mah and blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for mankind is our beautiful religion, our beautiful deen, Deenul Islam, the true religion. This is a ni'mah, a blessing for all mankind, not the people living in Arab Peninsula. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. This is a rahmah, mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a mercy for all mankind, for all mankind. So this is a message of peace. Islam is a message of peace for all mankind. The very word Islam means peace. So this is a peace. Islam brings a global peace for all mankind. And my dear brothers, this terrorism that media it portrays Muslim as a terrorist has nothing to do with Islam. This is a religion from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna al-deena inda Allahi Islam. The religion with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is only Islam. And no one can love his creation more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one can love mankind more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a peace. Everywhere you will see the message of peace, even in battlefield. Even in battlefield, when two armies are fighting, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to instruct his Sahaba commanders, "Ughzu wala taghullu," go fight and do not commit ghulul, do not steal, do not involve in stealing. "Wala tumassilu," and do not mutilate anyone, do not cut the pieces as people in Jahiliyyah used to do, do not dishonor the dead bodies. "Wala tumassilu wala taqtulu walida," and never kill a child. In another hadith, the Sahaba say, فَأَنْكَرَ قَتْلَ السِّبْيَانِ وَالنِّسَاءِ. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he disapproved of killing women and children. He prohibited the Sahaba to kill children and women. وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا وَلِيدًا. So these are the instructions given to the commanders. You will never see such instruction in any other religion. That you are going to fight, but there are some restrictions. Do not dishonor the dead bodies. Do not commit stealing. وَلَا تَغْدِرُوا. Do not violate the trust of your enemies. This is a beautiful religion. وَلَا تَغْدِرُوا. The Abu Rafi radiallahu ta'ala and a Sahabi, he was ambassador from Kuffar. He was not Muslim at that time. He came as an ambassador far to convey the message of his leaders. And he was a kafir, he was not Muslim. When he saw my beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then he realized that this face can never tell lie. So all of a sudden he embraced Islam on his own, without any pressure, without any forcing. And he requested Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, detain me here, I do not want to go back. And then he said, no, إِنِّي لَا أَخِيسُ عَهْدًا وَلَا أَحْبِثُ سَفِيرًا وَلَا أَحْبِثُ رُسُلًا. I do not violate the trust. I do not breach the agreement and covenant. And I never imprison the messengers. So this is beautiful religion. وَلَا أَخْبِثُ. Do not violate the trust. Do not involve in treachery. And my dear brother, even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded, وَإِنْ أَحَدٌ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ اسْتَجَارَ فَأَجِرْهُ حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ. Two armies are fighting, and a Harbi kafir, a covenant kafir, who came to kill Muslim, even if he requests you to grant me protection, Allah says, فَأَجِرْهُ. You must grant him protection. Even in battlefield, if kafir says, I want your protection, فَأَجِرْهُ. You must provide him protection حتى يسمع كلام الله, so that he may hear the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثم أبلغه مأمنا. Then it is your responsibility as a Muslim to escort a kafir, a non-Muslim, to a safe and secure place. A Muslim responsibility to take him to a secure, a place where he feels security. So these are the instructions of our religion. And my dear brother, even in battlefields, any Muslim, whether he is a commander, whether he is a king, whether he is a normal Muslim, whether he is a least in status, whether he is a man or woman, every Muslim is given this right. You will never see such right in any civilization, in any religion, in any community, in any country. That every Muslim is given the right to provide safety and protection to non-Muslims. Every zimmat al-Muslimina wahida yas'a biha adnahu. The protection of a one Muslim is on behalf of all Muslims. Is equal to by given by all Muslims. If one Muslim yas'a biha adnahu, even a least Muslim in status, in society, even he has the right to give protection to non-Muslims. يَسْعَى بِهَا أَقْسَاهُمْ. The even more distant Muslim who lives in villages, who is far away from capital, far away from battlefield, even he has the right to give protection to kuffar. Wallah, you will never see such an example in any community. That every Muslim has this right, men or women. On the day of Fath Makkah, on the day of conquest of Makkah, Sayyida Ummi Hani radiallahu ta'ala anha, the sister of Ali al-Murtada radiallahu ta'ala anha, she gave protection to two kuffar, those who were her relatives. They were worst enemy of Islam. Sayyidina Ali al-Murtada radiallahu ta'ala, he was trying to kill them because they were the worst enemy of our deen. But Sayyidina Ummi Hani radiallahu ta'ala, she gave them protection, aman, zimma. And when the Prophet sallam, he came to meet her, she said, sallam, my brother want to kill these two kuffar, but I have given them protection. What was the reply of our beloved Prophet sallam? On the day of conquest of Makkah, he said, Ya Ummi Hani, قَدْ أَجَوْنَا مَنْ أَجَرْتْ. We have given protection to those you have given protection. This is our good. This deen, it means to give protection to mankind, to people. And you know, in a unique incident of the conquest of Makkah, on the day of Fath Makkah, when the Prophet ﷺ, he conquered holy city Makkah, and he came to Kaaba, offered Nawafil, and then he came out of the Kaaba, and all of his worst enemies were standing in front of him with their heads down, shameful. All Sahaba, they were standing around them with sword in their hands. And if my Prophet had given one command, they would have been killed, all people. What was the response of my Prophet at that time? When it was the day to take the revenge from those who had taught the Prophet and his Sahaba, who had been killing Muslims during all the time before, who had forced the Prophet and Sahaba to exile from holy city Makkah, who had done so many wrong things with Muslims, and who had mutilated the Sahaba, Amir al-Mu'minin, Muawiyah, Amir ibn Muhammad radiallahu ta'ala, and some other Sahaba. All were standing. And my Prophet asked them a question, Ya Ma'ashara Quraysh, Ma ta'awna anni fa'ilu bikum? What do you think I would do with you? What is your opinion about me now? What should I do with you? They said, Khayra, Akhun Khayra, Akhun ibn Kareem, you are a generous brother and the son of generous father, honorable brother and the son of honorable father. We hope you will do nice, you will treat us nicely. And my brother, I say you only the same word that Yusuf alayhi salam said to his brother, La tathriba alaykumul yawm antum al-talaqa. No blame on you. Go, you are free. You will not be asked anything about the wrong deeds you have done before. This is a beautiful religion, my dear brother. And my dear brother, time very short. I wanted to discuss the time of Sahaba, the time of Umar, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, and Umar Khattab radiallahu ta'ala, and Ali al-Murtada, Uthman bin Affan. The unique examples of their rule. These are the unique rulers on the face of earth. When they died, they had nothing left at their homes. Islam trained people. Islam purified mankind. This is a message of purification. The Sahaba, Ridwanullahi Ajma'in, all over Allah, they are paragon of all virtues. They combine all best characteristics. You will never see people, such people in any other religion, my dear brother, except for Islam, because they were the student of our Prophet Muhammad. Let me give you only one example of Sa'id ibn Amir, radiallahu ta'ala. Most people they don't know. Most people they know the story of Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, and Ali, another famous Sahaba. Uthman ibn Amir, radiallahu ta'ala, he was the governor of Syria, Homs. He was a king. And once some a delegation from Homs came to Amir al-Mu'minin Umar ibn Khattab, radiallahu ta'ala, and Umar, radiallahu ta'ala, asked them that write me the list of four people from your area so that I would fix some benefit. So this is the concept of welfare society that Umar bin Khattab radiallahu ta'ala introduced 14 centuries ago, my dear brother. Our religion introduced a concept of welfare society. In UK, UK was established a welfare society in 1945, only just 70, 80 years ago. And Muslims introduced this concept and established a welfare society 1400 years ago. This is a beautiful religion. Write me a list of your people so that I fix some benefits for your poor people. And when the people, they wrote the names, and one among these names, one was the name of Sa'id ibn Amir radiallahu ta'ala. Their governor, their Amir, their king. And Amir, Umar Khattab radiallahu ta'ala, he asked them, who is Sa'id ibn Amir? He said, Amir, our king. He said, Amir ibn Faqir, is your governor, is your king poor person? He said, Wallah, he is the poor, most poor person among us. Some days come upon him that he find nothing at home to eat. Umar bin al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala, he wept till his beard became wet with the tears. And then he put some money in a bag, 1,000 dinar, and said, take this special gift from me and hand over to us, your king, your amir. And when this money came to Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, what was his response? He said, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Same was said Muslim, then this utter the same when they face any calamity, any loss. His wife became sad. What happened? Why are you so sad? He said, she asked, what happened? Amada Amir Mumini, as Amir Mumin Abu Khattab radiallahu anhu died, he said, Wallahi a'lamu min dhalik. More greater than that had happened. She asked, had the Muslim the loss of battlefield? He replied, Bal a'lamu min dhalik. But greater than that had happened. She asked, what happened? Why are you so sad? He replied, the dunya of fitna has entered into my home. In the home of Sa'id ibn Amir, she asked, she said, okay then, get rid of this fitna. Sa'id ibn Amir radiallahu ta'ala, he asked his wife, would you help me in this matter? She said, yeah. He said, okay, take this money and distribute to the poor of this my country. This is one of our predecessor, such one of our king, such one of our forefathers. A king and the most poor among his nation. And my dear brother, the another incident when Amir al-Mu'mineen radiallahu ta'ala and Umar al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala, he visited the homes and he came and met the people and he asked them, do you have any complaint about your Amir? They said, yes, we have four complaints about Sa'id ibn Amir. What is the first complaint? First complaint that he does not come out of his home until sun has risen very high, until the day becomes very hot. Second complaint about Sa'id ibn Amir, radiallahu ta'ala, that he never listens anyone at night. He never attends anyone at night. Third complaint about Sa'id ibn Amir, radiallahu ta'ala, that a day comes in the whole month that Sa'id ibn Amir, our Amir, our king, our governor, never leaves his home. He stays the whole day at home. And fourth complaint that there some instant comes upon Sa'id that he becomes faint, senseless, unconscious. Amir ibn radiallahu ta'ala, he prayed to Allah, Allah, I believe that Sa'id is a nice person. Allah, not let me be disappointed about Sa'id ibn Amir. So governor was brought and he was commanded to come there. And he was brought there. Sa'id ibn Amir, the governor, standing before Amir al-Mu'mineen. Sa'id, there are four complaints against you. What is the first? That you never leave home until very late, when the day becomes very hot. He said, Allah, I did not want people to know about my this problem. But now I have to explain, because I have no servant at home. And I help every day my wife in her kitchen, in cooking food, in preparing food. I myself prepare food. This is a king, a governor, a Muslim governor. These are the teaching of our beautiful deen. I prepare food. And when my children they have eaten the food, afterward I offer Salatul Duha, then I leave my home. Sayyidina Abu Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he said, Alhamdulillah, thank all thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Second complaint, then you do not attend anyone at night. He said, I did not want anyone to know about this, but now I have to explain. I have devoted my day for people, for mankind, and night. I have fixed for only for my Lord, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship. Hum bil-layli, hum bil-layli ruhbana wa min nahari fursana. These are our predecessors. I involve in worldly matter in daytime, but night, I have fixed only for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at night, I do not do any worldly matter, only to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And third complaint, that one day in the whole month I never leave my home. He said, yes, because I have no other dress, only one garment, one zawt. I wear the whole month, and in once a month I stay at home, I wash my clothes, and I wait until it becomes night. Afterward I leave my home. It takes become blind, then I will come out of my mouth. And fourth complaint, that once, sometime I became faint and senseless and unconscious, it was because I was among the mushrikun, non-Muslim. When they captured Khubayb ibn Adi radiallahu ta'ala and the Prophet Sahabi, and they were torturing him and they were trying to kill him, throwing stone and arrow toward him. And one of the mushrik, he asked, "Oh Khubayb, now you would wish, maybe you are thinking and desiring that you were safe in your home and Muhammad was in your place here." And he said, "At the name of Allah, I do not like even to you free me, and my Prophet's feet is pricked by any thorn. I even do not like this, that my Prophet was hurt by a thorn, and you free me and I go to my home." So this was the incident. Whenever I remember, I become unconscious because of the torture Kufar gave to Khubayb ibn Adi radiallahu anhu. My dear brother, these are the famous people of our, they are true representative of our deen. They are the true predecessor of our Muslim Ummah. There are so many people, 100 and 1,000 of Allah, if we start their seed of biography, it will take several khutbah. Look at the famous other Sahaba, the Tabi'een, Sa'id ibn Jubayr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and Fulayl ibn Ayyad, Abdullah ibn Mubarak, A'imma of Hadith, Imam Ahmad, Imam Bukhari rahmahullah, Imam ibn Taymiyyah rahmahullah, and Imam Bukhari, and Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Abdullah bin al-Mubarak, great muhaddith. His neighbor was a Jew, and he wanted to sell out his home. And the vendor Tujjar came and they asked him, "What is your demand?" He said, 2,000 dinar. 2,000 dinar is the price of my house. Who demanded a Yahudi? And he asked, "Very high price." He said, "Yes. 1,000 is the price of my house, and 1,000 dinar is the neighborhood of Abdullah bin al-Mubarak. This is the price of Abdullah bin Mubarak's neighborhood, because I am the neighbor of a Muslim. And a Muslim neighborhood becomes very expensive, because I am, my house is next to the house of Abdullah bin Mubarak rahimahullah." And he was, there are so many other virtues of Abdullah bin Mubarak rahimahullah. So may Allah make us a true Muslim like our predecessors. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow the mankind to learn the message of Islam, and may Allah convert them toward the beautiful religion of Islam. Ameen. Inna alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillahi wa ba'd. آج کے خطبہ جمعہ کا خلاصہ یہ ہے کہ اللہ تعالیٰ کی نعمتوں میں سے بہت بڑی نعمت یہ دین اسلام ہے. دین اسلام جس کا دہشت گردی کے ساتھ کوئی دور دور کا بھی تعلق نہیں, لیکن بدقسمتی سے ہر طرف جب بھی کوئی حادثہ ہوتا ہے اس کا تعلق مسلمانوں سے جوڑا جاتا ہے. یہ ہمارا دین یہ رحمت بن کے آیا, رحمت یہ نعمت بن کے آیا ہے, یہ انسانیت کے لیے امن کا پیغام لے گیا. جس دین کا نام ہی اسلام ہو, اس سے بڑھ کر اسلام امن کا علمبردار اور دین کون سا ہو سکتا ہے؟ یہاں ہر طرف امن ہی امن ہے, حتیٰ کہ میدان جنگ میں بھی کفار کو امن دینے کا اللہ نے حکم دیا ہے. نبی علیہ السلام صحابہ کو حکم دیا کرتے تھے کہ بچوں کو قتل نہیں کرنا, خواتین کو قتل نہیں کرنا, لاشوں کا مسئلہ نہیں کرنا, بد عہدی نہیں کرنی, عہد شکنی نہیں کرنی, چوری نہیں کرنی, مال نہیں چرانا. یہ اللہ تعالیٰ کے نبی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم صحابہ کو کمانڈروں کو حکم دیا کرتے تھے. اور پھر نبی علیہ السلام کی سیرت طیبہ ہمارے سامنے ہے. آپ نے اپنے بدترین دشمنوں کو بھی اس وقت معاف کر دیا جبکہ انتقام کا دن تھا. جب آج کفار پہ اللہ نے اپنے نبی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کو غالب کر دیا تھا, یہ وہ دن تھا جب بڑے بڑے ظالم آپ کے سامنے سر جھکا کے کھڑے تھے, اور اگر آپ اس سے بدلہ لینا چاہتے تھے آپ کے ایک اشارہ ابرو سے سب کی دردنے خم ہو کر قتل ہو سکتے تھے. لیکن اللہ علیہ وسلم نے فرمایا, لا تسلیم علیکم اليوم انتم الغلام, آج تم پر کوئی الزام نہیں, تم سب آزاد ہو. دین امن کا پیغام لے کے آیا ہے، ہمارا دین انسانیت کا خیرخواہ مطلب ہے، ہمارا دین انسانیت کی تربیت کرتا ہے، اور اسی لیے صحابہ کرام جو آپ کی صحبت سے فیض یافتگان تھے، تربیت یافتہ تھے، انہوں نے وہ مثالیں قائم کی ہیں، انسانی تاریخ ایسی مثالیں پیش کرنے سے عاجز ہے۔ اولئک آبائی فرینی بمثلہم، یہ ہیں ہمارے آبا و اجداد، کوئی ایسا لا کر دکھاؤں تو صحیح، عدل و انصاف کو وہ پہن کر لا کر دکھاؤں، انسانیت کے لیے عظیم ترین وہ کمانڈر کو لا کر دکھاؤں، ابو بکر صدیق رضی اللہ تعالیٰ جیسے، عمر بن الخطاب جیسے، علی بن المرتضیٰ جیسے، عثمان بن عفان جیسے، عشرہ مبشرہ اصحاب بدر، یہ وہ عظیم شخصیات ہیں، انسانی تاریخ ایسی مثالیں دکھانے سے قاصر ہے۔ اور پھر صرف صحابہ نہیں، تابعین، تبع تابعین، محدثین، ائمہ، یہ ہمارے دین کے اصل نمائندے ہیں، یہ ہمارے امت مسلمہ کے اصل، یہی ہمارے فور فادر ہیں، ہمارے ابا اجداد یہ لوگ ہیں، ایسی مثالیں۔ اگر کوئی بے وقوف ایسی حرکتیں کرتا ہے، اس کا اسلام سے تعلق نہیں ہے، اس کا امت سے تعلق نہیں ہے، تو آج ہمارے لیے ضروری ہے ہم ان کی سیرت کا مطالعہ کریں، ہم صحابہ کرام کی سیرت، ان کی حیات طیبہ کا مطالعہ کریں، اور ان سے محبت کریں، ان سے محبت یہی اصل نجات کی علامت، آج صحابہ کرام سے محبت نجات کی علامت ہے۔ جب آپ نے ایک صحابی نے پوچھا تھا کہ مت الساعہ، قیامت کب آئے گی، من ماذا اعددت لها، تو نے کیا تیاری کی قیامت کے لیے؟ اس نے کہا علی، میں تیاری تو نہیں کی، ولکن احب اللہ ورسولہ، لیکن میں اللہ اور نبی سے بہت محبت کرتا ہوں۔ نے کیا فرمایا؟ انت مع من احببت، جس سے تجھے محبت ہے تو قیامت قدر انہی کے ساتھ اٹھایا جائے گا۔ آج صحابہ کرام کی سیرت ہماری مشعل راہ ہے، ہم ان جیسے اعمال بجا لائیں، ہم ان سے سچے دل سے محبت کریں، اور ہم ان کی سیرتوں کو اپنی زندگی میں عملی نمونہ پیش کر کے دکھائیں۔ اللہ تعالیٰ ہمیں وہ عروج دوبارہ عطا فرمائے، اللہ تعالیٰ ہمارے دین اسلام کو حق الغالی فرمائے، آمین۔ اللہم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى، اللهم زيننا بزينة الإيمان واجعلنا هداة مهتدين، اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أيد الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم دمر أعداء الدين، اللهم إنا نجعلك في نحورهم ونعوذ بك من شرورهم، اللهم اشفنا واشف الضالين ومرضى المسلمين، اللهم اقض حاجاتنا وحاجات المسلمين، ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما، اللهم اغفر لجميع موتانا وموتى المسلمين، سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.